going to demonstrate how to prepare and charge a burette before any titration can commence. So for this experiment, we're going to need some deionized water and any charging solution that you may be using. For most of our titrations, we will be using a 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution. So for today's demonstration, I will be using that solution. But if you need to charge your burette with an acid solution, you would follow the same process. You would simply replace the sodium hydroxide solution with something else. So for today, our chemicals are deionized water and the 500 milliliter 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution that we prepared earlier. As for our equipment, which is the more exciting part of this demonstration, we will need to use a burette. And a burette is typically this long piece of glass that has a stopcock on the bottom, which could be made either of glass or Teflon. Ours today is made of glass. To suspend the burette, we are going to need a stand and a burette holder. And this is usually how it works. The burette holder will slide right into the stand, and then we tighten it so that it stays in place. And then the burette will slide in. The first thing we're going to do is open up the burette holder sufficiently so that the burette can slide in. And then there are some grooves in the burette holder, and we make sure that the burette fits inside those grooves and does not move. Once this is ready, we also need a waste container and a secondary container so that we're not using the large 500 milliliter volumetric flask to pour out the charging solution from. The most important thing about handling a burette is that we never adjust our height to position ourselves in alignment with the burette. We always adjust the position of the burette using the burette holder and potentially some of the space on the benchtop. So to get started, we're going to fill our burette completely with deionized water. To do that, first we make sure that our stopcock is in the closed position, and that means that it has to be perpendicular on the orientation of the burette. The next thing we have to make sure of is that we don't pour anything above eye level. And to get to that point, we need to make sure that for those of us more height challenged, the burette can be lowered and we should be able to see the top of it. So the way I do this is I slide my stand all the way to the edge of the table, and then I lower the burette so that I can see the top of it. If there is a sink that you can do this above, that is probably better, because then if you accidentally splash some of your water or charging solution, it will be contained inside the sink. But for today, I will trust my hands and I will pour my deionized water into the burette so it fills it completely. This will ensure that everything about my burette is going to be completely rinsed with the deionized water. So now to actually manipulate the burette, we need to put it back in its much taller position and set it aside. Now, most of the time, we are going to operate our burette over the foot of the stand, so it is best to get it in that position. Then, because whatever it is that we are washing out of with the water, it's going to be waste. So we bring our waste container right below our burette, and then we learn how to operate the stopcock. The first thing that we need to learn is how to completely open it and release our water in a straight stream. We hold the case of the stopcock and we open it up completely. At this point, the stopcock will be aligned with the orientation of the burette. And this will allow the water to flow out at its most rapid pace. Now for the different manipulations that are possible. We can slow it down a little bit. And for this demonstration, I will lift it above the waste container. I can slow it down to dropwise, and I can slow it down to a much slower dropwise. It is important to have control over every possible speed that we can get out of the burette. So slow dropwise, fast dropwise, slow stream, and fast stream. And if we're not sure, we need to try this until we are sure. The rinsing with the water should happen approximately 3 times to consider the burette rinsed. And you'll notice that the tip of the burette may hold on to some of the water. It's just regular deionized water after the third wash. After the first wash, it could be whatever it was before you attempted the cleaning process. So you do the washing with the water 2 more times. And then after you completed it 3 times, you're ready to add your charging liquid. For that, you're going to transfer a small amount of your charging solution into your beaker. You will close the stopcock. And once again, you don't adjust yourself to the burette, you adjust the burette to yourself. You set aside the waste container. You rotate the burette holder away from the benchtop so that when you slide the burette down, it can go below the benchtop's position. And when the top of your burette is at your eye level, that's when you add a small amount of your charging solution. A small amount would be anywhere between 3 to 5 milliliters. When you did that, then you release the burette holder. You take your burette with the stopcock still in the closed position. You tilt it sideways. And then you try to ensure that the top of your burette is right above your waste container, just in case your charging solution flows out. And then you let your charging solution slide almost all the way to the edge of your burette. And then you rotate this a few times. And when you're done, you set the waste container to the side. You bring back your burette holder, place your burette back in position, slide it above the waste container. And at this point, we're going to make sure that we are rinsing the tip of our burette. And we can once again practice our skills. Start with slow additions. And then more vigorous additions. This is also a good time to realize whether or not your burette is working appropriately. If you are unable to get all the different addition modes, it is a good time to evaluate the functionality of your burette and adjust before you begin any of your titrations. Once you're done, you close the stopcock and you repeat the same process of rinsing with your charging liquid 2 more times. Once you're done with the rinsing 3 times, then you're ready to fill your burette with your charging solution. And at that point, you want to make sure that you have a little over 50 milliliters of your charging solution. And once again, you don't adjust yourself to the burette, you adjust the burette to yourself. With the stopcock in the closed position, you lower the top of the burette to your eye level. And then you add your charging solution so that it goes a little beyond the 0 mark. I'm just a little above my 0 mark. So I will raise my burette. Turn it sideways, and then bring in my waste container. The next thing that I need to be mindful of is that the tip of my burette has a big air bubble. And And that should not be there, because every time we add a known volume of solution into our analyte container, whatever it is in the burette tip will be counted as added volume. And so if there is air, then we count extra volume of titrant that wasn't really there. So to remove that, we simply need to open our stopcock in the open position and release some of our sodium hydroxide solution. And when this tip is completely filled with the sodium hydroxide solution, we close the stopcock and we consider our burette charged. At that point, our top volume on the burette should be below the zero mark. And now when we are ready to begin our titration, we need to record the volume of the solution that is inside the burette. Now, mind you, this is not an exact volume. We will call it as a starting volume. This is the volume that we read at the beginning of the titration, and then we monitor the volume that is added throughout the experiment. So to record the volume, we're going to use a very similar technique to what we used with the 10 milliliter graduated cylinder. We are going to have two numbers after the decimal place. The second number will be our estimate. The only difference between a burette and the 10 milliliter graduated cylinder is that in the case of a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder, the zero is on the bottom and the 10 is on top, whereas in most burettes, with the exception of very few, the zero is going to be at the top and the 50 or other number will be at the bottom. So just like with any other measurement, we want to make sure that we bring the meniscus of our solution in the burette to our eye level. And that may require some adjusting of the position of the burette. So we lower it down. We make sure that the numbers are facing us and that the burette is standing straight. And when we look at it, we will record the volume as is included. In our case, the number is between 0.3 and 0.4, and it's closer to the 0.4, so it will be 0.39. That is our starting volume, and with that, we have a charged burette that is ready for its first titration.